Hello, I am a member of the Genome Connect and ClinGen Patient Data Sharing Program team. In this video, we will discuss how a variant is classified by a genetic testing laboratory. When an individual has genetic testing, genetic variants may be found. Every individual has variants. Some have the potential to impact our health, and others do not. After a variant has been identified, the next step is for the laboratory to interpret the variant to determine if the variant impacts how the gene works in the body and if it is associated with a health condition or places the individual at risk for a health condition in the future. This interpretation is known as variant classification. Genetic testing laboratories use different pieces of information to determine whether a variant may impact health. The laboratory may consider things like, does the variant affect the protein? Has the variant been seen in the general population or in individuals with symptoms? Was the variant inherited or passed down through the family? Have similar variants been seen in others? The laboratory then puts all of this information together to reach a classification. Variant classifications can fall into three main categories: benign, likely benign, uncertain, and pathogenic, likely pathogenic. The laboratory will classify a variant as benign, likely benign when it is not known to cause any significant health differences. If a variant is classified as pathogenic, likely pathogenic, it means that it is known to cause health differences that put a person at risk for a health condition or increase the chance of having a child with a certain condition. Uncertain variants are also sometimes referred to by the acronym VUS, which stands for variant of uncertain significance. This means that, at this time, there is not enough evidence to determine whether a variant causes health differences. As more information becomes available for variants, their classifications can change. Over time, as evidence becomes available, laboratories may learn more about a variant that downgrades it to benign, likely benign, or upgrades it to pathogenic, likely pathogenic. While the hope is to better understand VUS, our understanding of variants in any of these categories may change over time as laboratories learn more information. Because the laboratory's understanding of variants can shift over time, if you have had genetic testing, you are encouraged to contact the clinician that ordered testing or the genetic testing laboratory periodically to check in on updates to a variant's classification. A clinician can also help with other questions you may have about your results. Additionally, Genome Connect participants can opt to receive updates to their genetic testing results. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any general questions about this video or other genetics-related topics, you can reach us at info@genomeconnect.org or by calling us at 570-214-1721 or toll free at 855-322-7683. We hope you enjoy our other videos in this series.